protecting Mother Earth to save the human race. Our Star Blazers! Danger lurking everywhere, but we know we've got to dare. Evil men with evil schemes, they can't destroy all our dreams. We must be strong and brave. Our home we've got to save. We must make the fighting cease, so Mother Earth will be at peace. Through all the fire and the smoke, we will never give up hope. If we can win, the Earth will survive. We'll keep peace alive with our Star Blazers.
It's a miracle that the Argo's managing to survive. Commander Farrell, order your subspace submarines to surround the Argo and lure her into the fortress. When she's trapped, it'll be the end of her.
Aye, aye, sir.
They've got to be up to something. We can bet on that. But why?
How's the subspace sonar unit coming along, Sandor?
Just a little longer and I'll start it up.
If the skipper doesn't recover, what are we going to do?
It was just some shrapnel in his arm. Dr. Sane said it's not serious. We've got to just trust the doc.
Well, Nova, that does it. You sleep.
He'll be okay.
He made it.
Yahoo!
Dan, Doctor, how is he?
Is it bad?
Doctor, tell us.
He just has to sleep. Now, all of you, get back to work. You too, IQ-9.
Gangway, gangway.
IQ-9, get back to your station. Nova will take care of the commander.
Aye. Give them room. Give them room.
What am I doing in the hospital bay?
There was almost a direct hit on the bridge, and you were hurt.
Oh, that's right.
Lie down. You're not supposed to move.
Nova, help me. Take me to the bridge. I've got to be there. Help me to get up there.
You're in no condition to do anything. There's nothing to worry about. Xander and Mark and Jason are there. They're fully capable of commanding. And Derek, you're not indispensable. At least for now, at least till you're stronger.
And the enemy?
They stopped their attack. And there's not much damage. Leave the ship to the others. It's important that you get some sleep.
Nova, don't bother with me. Get back to your post.
I am at my post. Right now I'm a nurse and I'm taking care of the commander. On this mission, you and I are nothing more than the skipper and a member of his crew. And we both know that it won't be any more than that, don't we?
No more than that. I'm sorry.
We haven't been alone together for such a long time. But now, thanks to your wound, we'll be seeing a lot of each other. So there's something good about that space war.
Don't say things like that.
I told you not to move. Now lie down and be a good boy.
Nova.
How's the skipper?
He's doing great.
What do you mean? He's well already?
No, not yet, but I wouldn't mind special care like that.
What are you doing here?
What are you guys looking at?
Oh, they're holding hands.
Let me see.
I want to see.
Come on, let me get
out
of here. Let me... Oh! We were looking for the game room, sir.
We'll go face forward march.
See you later, Skipper.
That will soon come on.
Okay, it's ready. We'll install the subspace sonar right here, at the bottom of the Argo's bow. Let's put it in.
Anything yet, Sandor?
Subspace sonar is so sensitive it picks up the slightest movement or sound, so keep your eyes glued to the screen.
Number one, take position in front of their bow. Number three, take the stern position.
Are you mad? If any of our subspace subs make the slightest movement, they'll be picked up by the Argo sonar.
That's what I hope.
Oh.
Subspace one will move to front of Argo.
Subspace three to stern of Argo.
That's good.
You mean you're hoping that they'll be destroyed?
Yes. Picking up definite movement in front of the bow and behind the stern. It appears to be two vessels of some kind. The one at the bow is dead ahead at 12 o'clock, the stern at 6.
Get ready to fire wave explosives. 2-1 at 12 o'clock, get ahead.
2-2, take the stern target. Adjust scopes and angles for sonar range.
Adjusted scopes on tubes 1 and 2.
Wave explosive, fire!
Ships 4 through 9 assume G-plan formation.
All main guns, fire as they surface. Got him.
Oh.
And the rest of the fleet zeroed in on us while we were distracted by the first two. We fell for their trick.
Cease all firing.
Now we'll lure the Argo into our trap. Order ship 4 through 8 to retreat to the space fortress.
Aye, sir.
Ships 4 through 8 proceed to the fortress immediately.
Ships 4 through 8 proceed to the fortress immediately.
Enemy ships pulling back. They're behaving as if we've beaten them.
We've got to go after them. We've got to keep up the pressure. We can't let up for a minute. Mark, pour on everything we've got.
Wave engine room will need full power.
Full power he wants, full power he gets. Full power!
Admiral Smeardom, I've got good news. The Argo has fallen for the trick. She's now moving toward the fortress as planned.
Allow her to keep coming on. And while she's approaching the fortress, we'll be moving it forward at the same time to meet her.
Admiral Smeardom.
So, Argo, you are finally coming to meet your ultimate destiny, dust unto dust, etc. It might be amusing to take a look at the faces of the crew of what has been a most challenging enemy. Full speed ahead.
Roger, Admiral Smeardom. Full speed ahead. Jason, we're within firing range of the enemy ships. We'd better get ready to attack.
Right. Ready to wave it.
Look at that, sir.
I don't know what that thing could be.
Looks to me like a fortress.
They'll finish us off with that. It really looks invincible.
General quarters, man battle station. Man your battle station. Man your battle station. Man your battle station.
While we're firing all guns, we'll move to a position above them. Main guns, fire!
Go into reverse.
Mark, slow down and try to go underneath.
Okay, I'll try.
Well, Argo, I knew you would be clever enough to stay out of our trap. Now descend on them.
Descending!
I can't see a thing.
What happened?
Sandor, can it be?
The first thing we have to do is keep our cool.
Oh. How do you do, Argo? I'm surprised that you're all much younger than I expected. I am Admiral Smeardom, Supreme Commander of the Eastern Task Force of the Galman Empire.
The Galman Empire?
I wish to express my admiration for your fighting skill and your courage, but now you've become prisoners in our space fortress.
You prisoners?
Yes, young fellow, my prisoners, and I have a very interesting entertainment for you all. I will take you on a long journey with me to a certain planet called Earth, and together we shall witness the death of planet Earth. And then, after the Earth is no more, I will present you with a reward for your gallantry and courage. A reward I'm afraid you may not like.
You're wrong. We're not your prisoners. We'll blast our way out. Sandor, let me know as soon as the wave gun's ready. Look around. It's impossible to use it.
This dome is lined with those reflector panels. If we fire the wave gun, the beam will be reflected back at us.
I think that those panels are lined with impervious magnetic titanium, and our wave gun, or even a thrust by the full force of the Argo itself, would fail to break through.
Are you telling me there's no way we'll be able to escape?
Oh, Derek, we failed.
You've been running high fever. I think you were delirious for a while.
I must have had a nightmare that something's wrong out there. But tell me what's really been happening, Nova.
IQ-9's gone to get a report. He should be back here soon. Dr. Sane.
Commander, I'm sorry, but the news is bad.
Tell me, what happened, Doctor?
The Argo has been taken into enemy hands. We're prisoners. We're captives of the Galman Empire.
We're in their hands?
Commander! Commander, you had such faith in me, and I let you down.
You're wrong, Jason. You're not responsible for what's happened. You haven't failed.
But it was a trap, and I fell for it. I gave the orders that led us into it.
Never get discouraged. Anyone who loses his courage will surely face defeat. If you don't continue to fight, you have no chance to win. This may be our lowest point. It only means that from here there's nowhere to go but up. We haven't lost. We're getting ready to win.
How can we?
Jason, I want you to help me to get up. I'm going up to the command bridge. Help me.
Yes, sir.
Enemy ship that defeated General Dagon's fleet. We hold it in our fortress.
Are you referring to the ship belonging to that beautiful planet they call Earth?
Yes, sire. A most formidable ship and a great victory for us.
And what's the name of this most formidable ship?
The space cruiser Argo, O glorious one.
What was that name again?
The space cruiser Argo, sire. It is the warship of the planet I plan to give you as a special gift, my emperor.
You never told me that the name of the ship was Argo, Smeardom. Why not? Did you ever hear me give the order to attack the space cruiser Argo, Have I ever ordered you to capture her? And didn't I give you orders never to go near any of the planets in that solar system? What have you got to say, you idiot?
Sire, I'm terribly sorry. The Argo got in our way when we attacked the planet Birth.
Terribly sorry indeed. Put the Argo on the panel screen immediately. I want to talk to her commander.
Yes, sire.
The enemy's sending a communication. I'll switch it to the video panel.
My greetings, Argo.
He's back again.
Tesla.
So, Wildstar, now you are the Argo's commander. I know you've earned it and deserved it. Congratulations.
Deathlock, can it be that you've become the top man of the Galman Empire?
I am the Emperor of the Galman Empire, and as the Emperor, I must apologize for my subordinates attacking you without authorization. And as leader, it's my responsibility. I'm very sorry. Wildstar, I consider you, the Argo, and the Earth as my eternal friends.
Thanks, Deathlock. At least it's all over now. I guess you've done very well for yourself.
Good. Commander Wildstar, as a gesture of apology, I wish to invite you and the Argo to visit me here in the center of the Galman Empire. I suspect that you've been sent on a mission so far from your own planet because something dire is threatening the planet Earth. I'll help you if I can. Please come.
We're more than happy to accept your generous invitation, and we'll come.
It will be a pleasure to spend some time with you, Commander Wildstar. Admiral Smeardom will escort you here, and I shall prepare a suitable welcome for such honored guests.
Derek Wildstar wondered about the strange twist of fate whereby his enemies had proved to be led by an unknowing friend. What new fate now awaited the Argo as a guest of the Galman Empire? The tide of mankind, inexorable time, continued to ebb. Now there remained only 207 more days.
Alive with us.